Guten Morgen, East Region Playoffs. It is I, Pelvis Costello. I am here with the captain of the Maine Port Authority's Punchy O'Guts. How we doing, Punchy?
Great. Very excited about the bout.
That's what we are, too. One of the things that we saw, Maine coming in, definitely you guys have been you have been waxing in ascendancy right now in the Northeastern Region. We've been seeing you guys really pulling ahead. The last time that you took on Boston, only a 20-point differential up at your home team.
29.
There we go. Coming up. There you go. But coming into this, what sort of strategies and what is the mentality of Maine?
Well, we definitely want to win. You know, we've been trying to beat Boston since we've been a team. So really, what we want to do is maximize our ability to score points. And that really comes with Grimm, who's like our superstar jammer. So we're going with that. We're going to try to keep Boston. They're very good at like picking off and then coming back together. So we're going to try to avoid that. And stay focused and stay together as a team. We got a lot of new players. And, you know, it's like every season we sort of go through that where we're rebuilding. So we just do our best.
What a rebuilding year it has been, however, for both Maine and Boston itself.
Right. Yeah.
Both of these teams, a few core vets still in there from the years of this storied rivalry in Northeast. I mean, after all, we're warring for the Lobster, Maine Lobster, Pinchy McMasshole for the Boston Massacre.
I haven't seen him here. I think it might be because we hurt him a little bit, sort of attacked him.
That's true.
It was fun.
But yeah, this is absolutely great. So we're going to go this. Obviously, the winner facing later on today. So are you ready to go for that? How has the endurance been looking for Maine?
Oh, it looks fantastic. We train so hard, and we are on it. We're ready to go any second. We'll play another bout after this and another one.
We definitely saw you here for the crowd for the live feed. They were actually, you played against Gotham in a scrimmage for 30 minutes.
Yeah.
Definitely, you guys seem totally hungry and ready to compete.
Oh, yeah.
So we wish you luck.
Thank
you. Get out there, crack some skulls.
Yes, go Maine.
That's right. Take care.
Thank you.
And folks, you just keep staying tuned. This is going to be coming to you live in just a few minutes.
I'm Late Night Lyle along with Mellow Joe here live at the Duburns Arena in Baltimore, Maryland for the Women's Flat Track Derby Association East Region Playoffs presented by Blaze Media. Mellow Joe, what an amazing day two we're getting ready to start already.
Yeah, it's great to be here with you late night, and we've got a lot going on with this bout, Maine versus Boston. These two previously met in the season on April 23rd. Boston won 113 to Maine's 84. So Boston, of course, hoping for a repeat of that in the tournament today. Also, Boston lost yesterday to Charm City. Charm City won that one 191, Boston 88. So you have to wonder about the mental game and if that's going to affect Boston going into this one.
A lot of crazy things happening on day one. We also saw Carolina take on London. What happened there?
Well, Carolina and London, a bit of a surprise for a lot of fans. London winning that one.
It was not just a win, but in many people's opinion, a massive upset. Not to say that London isn't a great team, but it just shocked a lot of people, the skill level that London brought here to Baltimore.
Right. London winning that one 160 to 67 over the Carolina Roller Girls. So you could call that one a decisive victory.
In game three, Steel City took on Montreal.
That's right. Steel City defeating Montreal 134 to 88.
It was just an incredible day of derby, including some shocking things. If you've been paying attention this entire tournament, you've heard about this. If you're just now joining us, Dutchland, after winning, forfeits its game against Gotham City in what would have been game five.
That's right. You could call it a strategic forfeit, hoping to remain in play for fifth place and just keeping themselves fresh for tonight's bout at 6 p.m. Eastern.
In fact, a lot of controversy following that, posts going up, opinions on both sides as to, you know, whether or not that was something that should have been done, why it was done, and certainly opinions are going to continue to fly as we progress through this tournament about that. We'll see if it plays to their advantage throughout the tournament, or if it's something that comes back and haunts them in the public opinion polls. But we're here to play some serious roller derby, and we've already seen just a fantastic game here on day two with Montreal coming back against Carolina.
What a nail biter that was. I think I'm still sweating from the ending on that one.
It was just incredible. It was a close game through the entire bout, but all of a sudden at the end, the crowd was alive. And if you missed it, you really missed a great one. Mellow Joe?
Well, it looks like we are about to get underway here in Baltimore.
We are indeed.
It's the Nightmare on 95. Thanks once again for joining us at WFTDA.com.
We expect a close and exciting bout here as the Port Authorities out of Maine take on the Boston Massacre in what's going to be game two on day two of the East Region playoffs. And we have our first whistle. We're underway for some exciting roller derby action. Grim demise for the Port Authorities.
Claire DeWay is on the way on the line for the Massacre. She makes her way through the pack, or Grim Demise makes her way through the pack here.
Early butterflies here. Grim Demise is the lead jammer as Claire DeWay also finds her way out of the pack. Both girls on their scoring run. Pack putting on a bit of a tight but fast pace here as Claire DeWay and Grim Demise look to pick up as many points and knock off their goose eggs right in the first jam already. Claire DeWay through the pack. Picks up four, but it's Grim Demise now. Grim Demise looking to break her team's goose egg. Claire DeWay juts to the outside, gets pushed to the outside of the front straightaway. Goes to the inside, going into turn one. A hop, skip, and a jump. Calls off the jam, picks up three for her team, and we have a score in the first jam of 4-3. Advantage, Boston.
It's off to a great start for Boston so far. You know, these two teams have faced some common opponents. Dutchland is one of those. Maine lost to them 156-104. Boston won against Dutchland 142-104. But these two teams tonight, this afternoon, are very evenly matched. And I would expect it to be a back-and-forth contest, or at least very close throughout most of this bout.
Could have a real edge-of-your-seat bout here early as the fans are starting to fill up here in the Duburns Arena. And they're getting filled up with fantastic roller derby sugar hits jamming, along with Crystal Whip for Maine. Sugar Hits breaks through the pack first. She is the lead jammer. Crystal Whip trying to find her way past a wall of blue. Crystal Whip takes a spill going into turn four, and that may allow it. There it is. There's the thumb. A natural grand slam for Sugar Hits as we have our first grand slam of the bout.
That's five in the sky.
Boston Massacre trying to take an early lead as the pack slows to a stop. And Port Authority expressing their authority by trying to keep Sugar Hits back. Crystal Whip now making her initial pass, but it's Sugar Hits with a second grand slam, and she goes to double digits in this jam.
Sugar Hits probably looking to pick up a couple more points here to call off the jam. We'll see if that's what she does.
Goes to the outside and does call off the jam, denying Crystal Whip of any and picking up one more before she finally calls it. 11-0 with Boston increasing their lead. I tell you, Mella Joe, it is exciting to be here in Baltimore. The beautiful Baltimore. First time for us being in this city. We've been all over the place announcing grim demise for Maine. Little Payne for Boston. Payne moves with quickness, low and fast in the front straightaway, and she's the lead jammer.
Little Payne putting a little Payne on her opponents this morning.
Little Payne just very powerful footwork coming through the front straightaway as Grim Demise now makes her initial pass. But it's Little Payne already through the pack on her scoring run. She calls off the jam. Did she pick up all four? Yes, she did. As Boston tries to exert a pattern here and exert a little dominance, see if they can set the tone for the rest of the match.
That's right. Maine, this is their first appearance in a WFTDA tournament. They actually qualified in 2009 but declined that invitation at that time. But this year they're making their first appearance in a tournament, and they're doing very well in the playoffs so far.
Shatterly, Banger, and Bumpus, blockers for Boston up front, put up a wall, and it's effective. As Claire DeWay makes it through, she's the lead jammer. Claire DeWay has had an extremely effective weekend so far for the Boston Massacre.
Spry Icicle having a hard time making her way through the front of this pack.
First time jamming for Spry Icicle for Maine. Claire DeWay through the pack, picks up five, a natural grand slam for Claire. And we have yet to see any power jams yet. There is a blocker for Boston sitting in the penalty box, only person sitting in the penalty box currently. Spry Icicle has now made her initial pass, and it's Boston who has controlled Maine's jammer to allow for the point difference so far. Five so far, adds another three to it. Eight more for Claire DeWay as Boston increases their lead 27-3.
Rydell Skates, the proud partner and the official skate of the WFTDA. You'll see that a lot on the feet of many of these skaters tonight. That's Rydell Skates.
One of the most popular skate brands out there. Great both initial choice as well as a choice for veteran championship skaters. Rydell. Back to the action. Massive hit sends Shirley B. Slamming down to the ground on the inside of the turn two, and she's going to go to the penalty box for a track cut. Sugar hits out of the pack, but she's getting waved off. She's not the lead jammer, but she is in a power jam, and this is only going to mean more bad news for Maine's port authorities. Sugar hits, shoots to the inside of the back straightaway to pick up a grand slam. First one inside of a power jam for this bout. As the pack goes to a dead stop, trying to help Sugar Hits pick up as many points as possible. Double digits now for Sugar Hits as she goes to 10.
Good strategy from the pack there to just try and slow it down to get Sugar Hits through as easily as possible. That's always the plan. Sometimes it doesn't always go as planned. As we're seeing right now, she's having a hard time making her way through the pack here.
She takes a nasty hit from May Snap of the Port Authorities. Gets pushed to the inside of the front straightaway and has yet to make it 15, but she tries to step through and force her way through. Does so as I speak and picks up four more. A no pass, no penalty, picks up the third grand slam. Power jam is over. Sugar Hits makes it through with ease through the pack for five more, bringing her score by my count to 19. Mellow Joe, what does Boston need to do? What does Maine, the Port Authorities, need to do to get back into this? Because so far, Boston has just completely controlled the pack.
Right. Maine has got to they've got to use their blockers to create a hole in the pack, I think would be their best bet at this point, just to create that hole for their teammate, their jammer, and make that path to lead jammer a little bit easier.
Certainly. It has been since the first jam, Boston, that has set the tone early and has kept the tone in the sound of the music
Grim
that they
Demise
want.
Grim Demise makes her way through the pack first. She is the lead jammer.
First lead jam for Maine in some time. But if anyone can do it, it's Grim Demise, possibly the number one jammer for the Port Authorities.
Lil Payne now on her initial pass as Grim Demise quickly making her way through the pack once again.
Grim Demise down by Banger. But she calls off the jam and picks up four more. Maine looking to get their skates back into this, and doing so with a quickness as Grim Demise had fire on her skates trying to put her team back on the board.
Yeah, only about 10 minutes have elapsed off the clock so far. And one thing that we've seen here in the Eastern playoffs this weekend is a lot of times we're seeing the first 15 minutes not really indicative of the rest of the bout. So it's kind of hard to make any early predictions, even though Boston has what you might call a comfortable lead right now. We've seen those evaporate in the course of this tournament several times.
We'll see if the Port Authorities warm up here and prove themselves out in this bout as Crystal Whip goes to the outside, and Crystal Whip for the Port Authorities is the lead jammer. And now we're starting to see some of that consistency that you were talking about them needing to put forth.
That's right. Clarity Way, though, trying to catch up here.
Clarity Way for the Boston Massacre. Unable to get fourth, and we have our first 00 jam of the bout.
Yeah, that one's going to be a wash, but I wouldn't expect to see too many of those.
This bout already proving to be just as exciting as we had planned. A quick mention from Dr. Hauschka. Dr. Hauschka celebrates the fresh faces of the WFTDA. You can check out Dr. Hauschka, HAUSCHKA.com for more information. Back to the action. It is a third jam for the Port Authorities as Grim Demise is the lead jammer.
Grim Demise looking to get that momentum shifted in favor of Maine.
They've done a pretty good job so far. Now it's Boston's Sugar Hits making it out of the pack for her scoring run, but Grim Demise calling off the jam after she posts four more for Maine. You've talked about this many times, Mellow Joe. Sometimes it doesn't matter what the difference in the score is. If one side, if the trailing side has the momentum, they can nibble away at it piece by piece and eventually steal it away.
That's right. I think Maine, if they can continue to control these lead jams and just try and pick up 4 or 5 points at a time and call it off and just repeat that. Lil Payne now making her way up around the outside of the track.
It's going to be Shirley B. Slamming for Maine's Port Authorities, but it's Lil Payne out of the back first as she is the lead jammer, Boston Massacre, with the first lead jam in three. Payne bumping and weaving her way through the front straightaway, looks to find a hole, but it's May Snap putting the stop on her, getting some help from Lil Punisher as a blocker for the Port Authorities. And Little Punisher unable to make a full initial scoring run. Little Payne and Little Punisher up against each other, and it's going to be Little Payne through the pack with a natural grand slam.
Little Payne now with 9 points in the bout so far.
Payne looking to add to it, calls off the jam as Shirley B. Slammin' unable to make an initial pass through that entire jam. 8 points in total, though, for Payne.
That's right. Now, for Maine, they're putting up Spry Icicle. It's her sixth jam so far today. She jammed with some success earlier this weekend, but so far not able to put any points on the board for the Port Authorities.
Pack slowly crawling off the line, looking to control the clock. Spry Icicle going to the inside. It's Claire D. Way through the middle, and Claire D. Way squeezes her way like a tube of toothpaste through and becomes the lead jammer.
Yeah, just demonstrating right there why she is on Team USA. She makes it look very easy late night.
She does indeed. Team USA merchandise, their new logo looks incredible. As Claire D. Way picks up a grand slam, 5 more points. For the Boston Massacre, another natural grand slam. Only one blocker for the Port Authorities, sits in the penalty box, and it's been a fairly low penalty bout so far. Spry Icicle makes her initial pass late in the jam, and Claire D. Way calls it off, posting 4 more, giving another 9 points to the total of the Boston Massacre.
Grim Demise now on the Dr. Hauschka start line. Sugar hits on the line for Boston. She's had a great night so far. Four jams, but 30 points in just 4 jams.
Sugar hits on the outside. Sugar hits as the lead jammer with a nice move coming out of turn two. Looks like she caught a whip, and oh!
She's in a power jam late night.
She is indeed. As that's not going to be good news for the Port Authority. Sugar hits. Trying to go up against a couple of Port Authority's blockers. Cannot find a hole, goes to the outside of the back straightaway.
Little Punisher, she's just right in the way if cleared away.
And it's a grand slam for Sugar Hits. She calls off the jam, the power jam, still in effect. And that's going to keep Port Authority's jammer sitting in the box for another jam. Unable to get a fresh jammer out there. Mass proposal now being put on by Boston as they all take a knee. Trying to get their jammer out of the box as quickly as possible, off the line as quickly as possible. Jamming. It is Shank.
Shank is the lead jammer. And it looks like Grim Demise making her way out of the penalty box here and joining the pack.
Power jam is over, and a quick move down low from Grim Demise. But it's Ivana Shank who calls off the jam, stopping the speed of Grimm. Five more points for Boston as Hang Chad, referee, chose the fifth. instead of just the four, currently 78-11 with Boston firmly in the lead. Longtime fans of roller derby have seen spreads like that overcome before. It could mean the difference.
Well, we saw one
in a halftime
earlier today between Montreal and Carolina.
We did. Montreal having some fantastic final jams to steal that one. In just the bout right before this, Grim Demise on the outside. Grim Demise is the lead jammer. And Grim Demise showing she is worth every single bit that Bain has entrusted to her to take care of. Grim Demise through the pack on the outside, a turn two, calls off the jam, but not before posting four more points for the Port Authorities.
You know, one of the people helping with tonight's broadcast, making it possible, Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solutions.
Spry Icicle and Sugar Hits on the line for Boston and Maine. Sugar Hits for the Massacre. Spry Icicle for the Port Authorities. And it's going to be Sugar Hits out first. She's the lead jammer. Spry Icicle also out of the pack. Both girls on their scoring run. But man, what a fast pack. As the Massacre down two blockers into the penalty box with the Port Authorities only down one. This could be another advantage that Maine can take to the bank in terms of getting back into this game.
Yeah, Sugar Hits has had a great bounce so far at 40 points so far of the 78 that Boston's got on the board. Both jammers making their way to the pack, skate to skate.
Sugar Hits jostling for position along with Spry Icicle, as neither one with a real advantage. Sugar trying to go to a defensive position and just shut down Spry. At this point, it becomes almost more of a game of time that does score with such a difference.
That's right. When you've got the lead like Boston does right now, time is on your side. You've got no real rush here. Just try and milk the clock as much as possible is not a bad strategy.
Not at all. As we approach the 8-minute mark left in the first half, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, you at home, if you go to WFDDA.com, which you're already at, but go to another place and find the brackets, you can fill out your predictions and possibly win. Back to the action. We'll have more information on that in just a moment. Crystal Whip for Maine, but it is Ivana Schenk with the lead. Lead jam for Ivana for the Boston Massacre. Now Crystal Whip breaks out of the pack. This is Crystal's sixth jam so far. 4 points for Ivana as she calls off the jam, though, limiting Maine to another goose egg.
We've seen, like you said earlier, relatively low penalties, and so far that's still the case, although Boston picking up quite a few more than Maine. Maine only with 3 penalties total so far. Boston picking up about 8 so far.
Battle of the Killer D's. Claire D. Way for Boston Massacre. Grim Demise for the Port Authorities. Grim Demise on the inside with a hop, but it costs her as she goes down coming out of turn 2, and that's going to allow Claire D. Way on the outside to break through to become the lead jammer. Grim Demise being sent to the penalty box. That's going to leave Claire DeWay in a power jam. and Boston with another opportunity to increase this already sizable lead. Cleared away through the pack. Only four, a no pass, no penalty. Prevents the full grand slam. And here's an opportunity for Maine as Clarity Way gets sent to the penalty box with a track cut on the outside of turn one.
That's going to release Grim Demise from the penalty box in there for a low block.
Grim Demise, of course, will only spend, or excuse me, Clarity Way will only spend the amount of time that Grim did, but that was most of the penalty, I would say.
Right.
But still, power jam opportunity in the hands of the Port authorities, and the speedy Grim Demise trying to make advantage of it. Grim Demise goes to a stop pack and glides through, keeps her balance with a circus move on the outside, and picks up four.
A beautiful move, that agility of Grim Demise. It's just incredible.
You can hear it from the home crowd. Not sure if our mics picked that up or not, as a lot of excitement bursting through the air. Grim Demise tries to call off the jam, but was not lead jammer. Goes back through and picks up another 4 or 5. It was 5 on the first pass, and I believe 4 on the second, for a total of 9. As the referees quick to make sure that the appropriate score given.
Meantime, Lois Carmen Dominator going to the penalty box near the end of that jam, so she'll begin this jam in the box. Boston down a blocker as their pivots in the box.
Crystal Whip for the Port Authority up against Star Jammer Sugar Hits for the Boston Massacre. Crystal Whip getting pushed around by Anorexia. But she goes to the inside of turn three and becomes the lead jammer.
Crystal Whip in 7 jams so far tonight, but not able to pick up any points. And she looks determined to change that with this jam, and she does.
Oh, nasty. Just absolutely brutal hit put forth by Anorexia. A can opener.
Looks like we've got some a misconduct call.
Shuts her down, and Crystal Whip
getting a little physical on the track today.
Crystal Whip with a fantastic jam, picking up some more points for her team, but
looks like she's visiting the medic off to the sidelines here.
She's gonna.
We hope everything is okay.
The floor can be rather unforgiving, Mellow Joe.
You know, speaking of the floor here, the skaters are on a sports tile for this tournament, and I think they'd probably use probably a 90 to 92.
I would say so. It's
for their wheel selection.
From what we've been able to gather, just in our discussions, it seems to be a somewhat sticky floor. But as the tournament goes on, and this type of floor gets dirtier, we may see it get slicker, just because of the nature. Of course, they're cleaning it regularly, so that's
a lot of the skaters here using Atom Wheels. Atom Wheels, the official wheel of the WFTDA.
Want to remind you, as I was talking about earlier, Mellow Joe, the brackets, you can go on to another place on WFTDA.com, because you're already there if you're watching us live here in Baltimore. And fill out the brackets. If you have already, if you filled out all 5 before the Big Five started and you are correct, then you have an opportunity to win a massive prize, a trip, an all-expense-paid trip to next year's World Championship by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. But if you didn't, it's not too late. You can still fill out the brackets for the other 4 that are left, and you can still win other prizes.
Late night, I'm a little distracted by what's going on there. amongst the skaters, just having a little slapping match.
The skaters will entertain themselves while the zebras are away.
Always discussing. Time for some silliness on the track. Never too busy for that. You know, Spinland Media, they make it. You need it. We make it. Apparel, websites, and the rules app. So they could have the solution that your league needs.
They could.
Spinland Media.
The zebras, the referees, the officials, if you will, were discussing the misconduct major for blocking a down skater and defining who would get that penalty and whether or not it was.
You know, we've seen a lot of great action so far. Claire DeWay with 25 points for Boston. Sugar Hits with 40 points for Boston. Grim Demise, 25 points for Maine. That's almost their entire score. You know, you have to wonder if these skaters are competing for the MVP because the MVP gets a little prize pack. Union Vacations is proud to provide the 2011 WFTDA MVP with a one-week getaway to Mexico.
Wow. If you're wondering whether or not Grim Demise is okay, she's back on the track with a star in her head again for Maine and jamming like she has something to prove. And she does. She has to prove a big win in the column of the Port Authorities. Not really so much to prove, but to gain, if you will. Grim Demise is the lead jammer.
In a power jam.
Sugar Hits sitting in the penalty box after the misconduct penalty, we believe. Grim Demise on the outside at turns 3 and 4. Oh! Just absorbs a nasty hit from Ginger Kid. Shuts her down, but she gets back up to finish off the scoring pass. Juice to the outside past Shark Week and picks up the grand slam.
Ginger Kid almost picked up an assist on that, pushing Shark Week towards Grim Demise.
Grim Demise calls off the jam. 0 points for Boston in Maine. Nibbling away at the lead that the Massacre has posted.
That's right. They're kind of sticking to that strategy of trying to control the jam, post a few points, and then call off said jam. If you rinse, lather, repeat, that's how you can come back from a large deficit.
Under the two-minute mark as the Massacre sets up the mass proposal. It allows the jammers to get called out immediately. It's going to be Claire DeWay on the outside of turn one to be the lead jammer. Effective use of the mass proposal. Spry Icicle now making her initial pass for Maine, but it's Claire DeWay already through the pack with 4. She is not likely to allow any from Spry Icicle. And as I say it, I'm wrong. Icicle shoots through. Claire DeWay decides why not and lets Icicle pick up 4 more of her own.
It looks like she decided to answer those points with some of her own, only picking up 3 though.
7-4 with the advantage going to Boston. Bringing our current score, as you can see there, 93-37. And this, we'll see if we're going to have time for one more jam. I believe we are. We have an official timeout called.
You know, safety is important in roller derby late night. It's something that these skaters take very seriously. And one way that they do that is by using Pro-Tec Dent Mouth Guards. The first thoroughly scientific mouth guard for the derby player. It's designed specifically for use in roller derby play. It's not just some generic sports mouthpiece. It's the real deal for roller derby.
This is actually an official review here in the center. Don't forget, courtesy of Blaze Streaming Media, you're going to be able to catch the entire Big Five tournament, all four regional playoffs, and the World Championship in Denver, Colorado, live on WFTDA.com, where you're watching it right now. If you're not already on the HD stream, you need to check it out. It's beautiful.
We're actually watching it on our monitor here at our desk right now, and I can tell you, if you're not on the HD stream, you're really missing out, because the only thing better than live roller derby is live roller derby in high definition. You know, late night, we spend a lot of time on the road, and one of the things that we can do on the road is read while we're traveling, not while we're driving, of course, but...
Not again.
We like to read 5 on 5 magazine, the official magazine of the WFTDA. That's 5on5.com.
5on5 always has a ton of exciting articles and information about your favorite sport, roller derby, as well as other skating events. Check it out. Back to the action as the timeout is over. On the line, Ivana Schenk for Boston Massacre up against Grim Demise for Maine's Port Authority.
The official review there. Excuse me.
We'll get that in just a second, Mellow Joe, as it is Grim Demise. Excuse me, Ivana is the lead jammer. But and it was not Grim Demise as the jammer. I stand corrected. That's Shirley B. Slammin jamming for Maine. Shanks calls off the jam, a double goose egg jam, and that, I believe, is going to be the end of the first half.
We're in halftime. The score stands at 93, Boston, Maine with 37. 20 jams so far in the first half.
A very fast pace. You were talking about the official review. What happened there?
The official review was they were trying to determine whether or not there should have been a illegal block penalty as one of the skaters fell and another fell on top of her. They decided it was cool, so no penalty on that one.
Interesting.
Claire DeWay with 32 points so far. Sugar Hits with 40 of her own. Lil Payne with 12, and that is why Boston is out way ahead, but... Maine, not to be outdone, Grim Demise with 30 points of her own, Spry Icicle with 4, and Crystal Whip with 3. So it's just hard to compete with two jammers like Claire DeWay and Sugar Hits on the same team.
Absolutely.
Hard to stop those two, but what Maine needs to do if they want to come back and gain the lead, they've got to figure out a way to neutralize one or both. Claire DeWay or Sugar Hits, they've got to figure out a way to neutralize one of those skaters to get back in this thing.
We'll find out if the Port Authorities are able to come up with any answers in the locker room as we go to halftime. You're watching the WFTDA East Region Playoffs live on WFTDA.com. I'm Late Night Lyle,
along with Mellow Joe.
We'll be back in just a moment. Stay tuned. Here we are back live at the East Region Playoffs for the Women's Flat Track Derby Association in Baltimore, Maryland, at the Clarence DuBurns Arena. Late Night Lyle here alongside Mellow Joe for what has been all Boston in Little Maine in Game 2 of Day 2. Mellow Joe, your take on the first half.
Well, the first half we saw Boston just begin to pull away with it about halfway through the first half. Sugar Hits with 40 points so far, Claire DeWay with 32, just really racking up a lot of points for Boston. Maine trying to fight back, Grim Demise with 30 points of her own, but it's just not enough to hang in there with Boston so far.
What do you think Maine needs to do here to get back into it? Because obviously it's not an insurmountable difference. It's
right.
a large difference, but something that, that Maine's going to have to make some key changes in, obviously.
Well, it looks like the action is about to get back underway here. Grim Demise on the line for Maine.
For the Boston Massacre. Going to be... Looks like...
Claire DeWay taking a spill there in the first turn.
It is Claire DeWay. Hits the ground hard right here by our feet, but she manages to get back up and break through first anyway, as she is the lead jammer. Grim Demise now making her initial pass. Claire DeWay on the outside finds a huge gap in the back and breaks through for four.
Grim Demise there approaching the pack. Claire DeWay smartly calls off that jam before Grim Demise is able to add any to her 30 points of the evening so far.
To remind you that this East Region Playoffs is brought to you in part by Honest Tea, donated for our volunteers here. Thank you to Honest Tea.
Also, thank you to Vitamin Water. They also donated some hydration for the skaters and officials today. We're back in the action.
On the outside, Schenck is the lead jammer for the Boston Massacre. Spry Icicle trying to break the pack for initial pass for Maine's Port Authority. Icicle freezing up in the front straightaway. Unable to make it past Bumpus as blocker Anita Banger gets sent to the penalty box with her fourth minor for Boston Massacre.
Bumpus and Shatterly working in tandem there to keep Spry Icicle back, but she manages to make her way past them.
Anita Banger, the only blocker in the penalty box, only skater in the penalty box, as a natural grand slam for Schenck. It is only now Spry Icicle is able to break through her initial pass. And, Schenck gets tripped up in turn one, smacks the ground hard, and calls off the jam.
Sounded like there was a lot of force behind that fall.
It did.
Looked very frustrating. That look on her face says a whole lot.
A very flat splat for Schenck.
Anita Banger and Bumpus will begin this jam in the penalty box. That could present an opportunity for Maine here to try and get that lead jammer status with two of the Boston blockers in the box.
Almost as powerful as a power jam as having your opponent's team, their pack cut in half. Sugar Hits jamming for the Boston Massacre. For the Port Authorities, for the first time tonight, it's Itsy Bitsy Fighter. Itsy Bitsy Fighter is the lead jammer, but Sugar Hits tight on her skates as Hits makes the pass in the front straightaway. Itsy Bitsy Fighter with the lead, but Sugar Hits with the speed. As Sugar Hits is denied any points, Itsy Bitsy Fighter calls off the jam. Massacre has passed the century mark.
And they're looking to add some more to it. Claire DeWay on the jammer line this time, going head-to-head with Spry Icicle for Maine.
Grim Demise as a blocker this time for Maine's Port Authority, sitting in the penalty box, making sure not to give up a power jam as a jammer.
Boston looking to eat a little time off the clock there, get their bench back in to play here.
Full pack for the Massacre. It's Claire DeWay and Spry Icicle as Claire DeWay gets some help from Bumpus and becomes the lead jammer. A quick shove coming out of turn two, allowing for the L to be raised high. Spry Icicle, yet to make her initial pass, looks to the inside and goes to a defensive position, but gets shut down by Shark Week.
We've seen a lot of great blocking from Boston, and I think that's part of the reason we're seeing such a deficit for Maine here is that there's a lot of tremendous teamwork in the pack for Boston.
Boston, who had a really tough night last night in the final game of day one, is shining strong here early in day two. Spry Icicle now with her initial pass, but Claire DeWay picking up a grand slam and calling off the jam before Icicle can take anything away from it.
Claire DeWay, you see her on your screen there. She's an incredible skater late night. She's had a great day so far and a great showing at this tournament. She's scored 41 points so far. Boston now with a commanding lead here, 110-37.
Jam gets going.
Shirley B. Slamming now on the line for Maine.
In a very slow start, almost a dead stop for the pack as Shank for the Boston Massacre pushes her way through turn two to be the lead jammer. Shirley B. Slamming trying to find a path through turn four. Can't seem to get past the defense as a three wall blocks Slamming, but breaks up and allows her to go to the inside past Mames to make her initial pass. Only got to have the jam called off by Shank as Massacre adds four more to their lead.
Late night, we've got to thank Wicked Skatewear. Wicked Skatewear sells all kinds of, well, skatewear.
Hence the name.
Thank you, Wicked Skatewear, for helping make this event possible.
A lot of jostling in the pack as the pack starts to become very aggressive now. Sugar hits, getting recycled to the back. Grim Demise trying to fight her way on the outside and does so as Grim Demise is the lead jammer. Sugar hits finding the same hole and breaking through. Both girls on a scoring run, but the speedy Grim Demise is in control. Demise goes into the pack, calls it off, but both jammers able to pick up a single point before the fourth whistle is blown.
Sin City Skates helped make tonight's broadcast possible. Sin City Skates is ready to fix your gear.
An official timeout being called. We'll find out more about this in just a moment. Here you see Spry Icicle and several of the other port authorities, along with a bench of the Boston Massacre.
Boston team all smiles here.
And rightfully so, as they lead 115-38. So far, Mellow Joe, I know we both filled out our brackets. How's yours going?
Mine is actually holding up pretty well. I've had one wrong so far, but, that's tournament life. Can't get them 100%, and if you do, it's sometimes more luck than skill. It's been a lot of surprises here this weekend.
As indeed. Mine got shattered on day one. And
I don't think you were the only one.
I don't think so.
You know, there's a lot of... A lot of great photographers in the world of roller derby, but none quite like Axel Adams, Jules Doyle. The new derby photo book from Jules Axel Adams Doyle is out. You can check it out at nomercybook.com. Fans of the sport may have seen a lot of Axel Adams photography and maybe not even realized it, but some great work there.
getting back to the action as the pack sets up for the next jam. This is jam 27 of this exciting bout between Boston and Maine.
The official timeout there is to basically correct the scoreboard, had 1 point in question, and that will award an extra, well, not an extra point, but an additional point to Maine.
Every point matters. Anna Reksha being sent to the penalty box, blocker for the Boston Massacre. Clarity Way jamming for the Massacre. Shirley B. Slammin, though, is the lead jammer for Maine's Port Authority. Pack spreads out a little bit. LCD and Mames trying to stop Slammin. Slammin slams into the back of them and picks up zero, a double zero jam. And for those, if you at home, if you're wondering why they didn't pick up the points from the penalty box, well, you have to pass a skater on the track before you get those points.
That's right. They call those ghost points, but you can't be awarded those until you make contact with the pack. So
you pass an opposing skater.
That's right.
So then she would have, had she just done one, she would have instantly got four, but the jam got called off before she got any. Grim Demise in the next jam is the lead jammer.
With a burst of speed through the pack.
Port Authority starting to put together a bit of momentum here.
Little Payne now on her scoring run.
Little Payne, the coach for Boston Massacre. And a hop for Grim Demise as she stays on the inside, calls off the jam and picks up four.
Iron Doll Clothing helped make today's broadcast possible. One-of-a-kind uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee. That's Iron Doll Clothing. They actually designed the Team USA uniform, and it looks great.
It does indeed. The new logo for Team USA is fantastic. And we've had an opportunity to look at the new uniform, and it is equally nice. As we get back to the action, Sugar hits, breaking through on the inside of turn two to be the lead jammer for Boston. Shirley B. Mames out of the pack, both girls on a scoring run, but it's Sugar hits. Sugar hits now. Looks to the inside, tries to make it past Punchio Guts, does so, calls off the jam, and extends the lead by four for the Massacre.
Punchio Guts has contributed to the roller derby community with her YouTube channel. So if you're a new fan to the roller derby community, you can check out her YouTube channel and learn a little bit about strategy and just some of the basics.
It's a
great starting point if you're a new fan.
That's actually a good starting point if you really want to know some more in-depth stuff.
That's very
about
true.
Derby. Punchio Guts has definitely contributed quite a bit. Another staticky start for the pack as Clarity Way pushes her way on the inside of turn two, and she's the lead jammer for Boston.
Spry Icicle caught up in the pack again.
Only one blocker sits in the penalty box.
She's run up against the Great Wall of Boston here, having a hard time climbing it.
Spry Icicle down the outside makes an initial pass, but it's a natural grand slam for Clarity Way. As she calls off the jam.
She called it, but I think Spry Icicle may have picked up.
She picked up four.
Wow.
So 4-5 advantage going to the Massacre there. As Clarity Way unable to call it off in time to prevent the allowables from the Port Authorities. Hit a hard wall of main blockers and just comes to a dead stop in the back straightaway. Ginger Kidd sitting in the penalty box for the Boston Massacre. Maine with a full pack on the track. Grim Demise jamming for Maine. Boston sending out Little Payne. Little Payne on the outside takes a spill. Grim Demise trying to find a path on the outside of her own. Little Payne trying to squeeze through the middle now. Neither jammer with the advantage, but it's Little Payne now on the front straightaway coming out of turn four. She's the lead jammer. Grim Demise finding the same hole, and she's on her scoring run as well. And these two jammers are moving at a blistering pace, lighting up the track, skate and skate together.
We're seeing the pace at, of the pack at a moderate rate as well.
Grim Demise on the inside tries to take an advantage over Little Payne, but Payne calls off the jam and forces no points on either side.
Little Payne having a rough go of it there.
As long as the spread remains like it is, no points is good points as far as Boston is concerned. And we have a team timeout being called by Maine.
You know, Maine, they lost two of their star skaters this year, Polygon and Barbara Ambush, to the Texecutioners, and that could be part of the reason why we're seeing such a gap in the score as well. But they've been experimenting with new strategies this year with pretty good success. I mean, it did get them to the Eastern Regional Playoffs. So although it may not be reflected in the score today, Maine has had a wonderful season.
No matter what, watching here live at the East Region Playoffs, we're seeing just top-level roller derby, even in a bout with a spread like this. Still in the middle of a team timeout as we get ready to go to the next jam.
Late night, I think I know what I might get you for Christmas.
Oh?
I think I might do some shopping at Derby Skins for you.
Derby Skins?
Derby Skins loves making your hiney shiny.
I do love having a shiny hiney.
Well, that's where you need to go, Derby Skins.
I'll have to check it out. Back to the action.
We're certainly a fan of their work. And we're off to a very slow start here.
Jim moving at a snail's pace, but it's going to be a fourth minor for Mother Bones, blocker for the Port Authority. She's going to be sent to the penalty box. But an effective move for the Massacre as Sugar Hits as the lead jammer.
Sugar Hits with 45 points before this jam. Let's see if she can pick up some more here, and she does.
Spry Icicle, jammer for the Port Authority, unable to break the pack, and that's going to allow for a natural grand slam for Sugar Hits.
Sugar Hits with 5 in the sky.
And Spry Icicle trading some bumps with every single blocker on the Boston. It's almost like they were going to start moving in other blockers off the bench just to hit Spry Icicle on that pass.
Boston has displayed some incredible teamwork in the pack tonight.
So that wasn't a waterfall, that was a rock fall against her. In the meantime, a second grand slam for Sugar Hits sends her to double digits in this jam as she squeezes through the middle of turn two and picks up a third for 15 so far.
Sugar Hits there just saw an opening and skated through it, and it was just a split second that opening was there, and she just instinctively skated through it. Just an incredible display of athleticism there.
Sugar Hits, a dog pile. On the outside of the front straightaway, Sugar Hits manages to stay in. Mother Bones, who's just coming back onto the track, goes right back off the track.
Worst possible place to pick up a penalty is right on the other side of the penalty box as well, because you've got to skate all the way around before you can start serving your penalty.
20-point jam for Sugar Hits. As she adds to what has been thus far a Boston Massacre of its own against Maine's Port Authority.
Grim Demise is going to take the line for Maine on this jam. She's got 36 points so far.
Adam Ames, blocker for Boston, sitting in the penalty box, along with Mother Bones.
Grim Demise makes her way up through the inside and then out to the outside to become the lead jammer.
Grim Demise and Claire D. Way speeding across the track as, whoa, Grim Demise calls off the jam through the back with a quickness and is able to pick up two unanswered points for Maine.
Yeah, I had to wait for the referee on that one because it was just so close. It was hard to tell how many she picked up, only picking up two. But, man, that was close.
It was. It was just a beautiful move, a hop through the middle of the pack. As she's in the middle of calling off the jam, you're able to continue to score points until the fourth whistle is blown, and she took full advantage of that. Mass proposal put on by Boston. And they crawl as Little Payne fights through the outside along with Itsy Bitsy Fighter. Excuse me. Some jostling around with Little Payne and Itsy Bitsy Fighter. Fighter as a blocker for the Port Authorities. It's Spry Icicle jamming for Maine. Icicle on the outside makes her initial pass. But Little Payne already through the pack on her first scoring pass. Calls off the jam and adds four more.
Let Vanilla Derby take you to success with our brand new top grain leather Renegade and straight jacket boots. That's from Vanilla Skates. Ginger Kid jamming for the first time in this bout.
Ginger Kid, wow, on the outside is the lead jammer. And just quickly making use of a hole exposed by her teammates. Shirley B. Slammin' is jamming for the Port Authorities. And she's still stopped up in the pack. Tries to make it past Mames, but Mames pushes to the outside. Tries to make it around, takes a spill. And now makes her initial pass, but it's 4 points, 5 points now. A natural grand slam for Ginger Kid on her inaugural jam of this bout.
Ginger Kid, you know, has that advantage of knowing how to think like a blocker. She's not normally in the jammer rotation, but I suppose with a commanding lead, it's a great opportunity to get some high-level experience in for some of the people that you wouldn't normally see in the jam position.
Perhaps giving their jammers a little bit of a rest. Rotating in some of their blockers. Anita Banger for Boston's Massacre, sitting in the penalty box. Grim Demise, star jammer for the Port Authorities, lined up on the jammer line up against Claire D. Way. And it's going to be the agile Grim Demise on the outside of turn one to be the lead jammer. Claire D. Way looks to hunt her down as they are in a dead heat around the track.
I hear some USA chants, and that's for Claire DeWay, skater for Team USA and also the Boston Massacre.
Team USA will be trying to take on
the world.
The world indeed. 14 or 15 other countries, I believe. In the World Cup later on this year. More information on that online.
Late night, you can take your league to the next level with skate court roller derby flat tracks. It's a great way to get the skate floor that you need.
We haven't seen a lot of a lot of slipping and sliding. We've seen a whole lot of sure feet here on that type of court.
That's right.
certainly seems to be the preferred court for this tournament. Right now, the officials are double-checking the score to make sure it's correct. The score is, as it stands, 162 to 49. We'll see if it changes any.
Little Payne, the skater you see on your screen there, she's picked up 16 points so far for the Boston Massacre. Today's broadcast has been made possible by Green Monster Roller Sports, selling antique boots, reckless wheels, and moto bearings, revolutionizing roller derby. Green Monster Roller Sports.
The entire Big Five tournament series by the WFTDA, brought to you by Blaze Streaming Media, as you're watching it live on WFTDA.com. Be sure to fill out your brackets, and if you do so correctly, you have a chance to win. More information on that on WFTDA.com. Still in the middle of this official timeout. Mellow Joe, I know your prediction was a Boston win.
Correct, but it was not a Boston win with this much of a point spread. I expected a little bit of a closer game. I was predicting more in the 20 to 30 point spread, but Boston exceeding my expectations for the day, and having some excellent defense that Maine has had a hard time penetrating today. So Boston with a spectacular day here against Maine.
The score was off slightly, and it has been adjusted. Boston corrected down to 153 to Maine's 49. And so Boston with a three-digit lead.
We've seen some hard hits in this bout late night, and Dr. Hauschka is the way to fix them. Dr. Hauschka, the WFTDA's official bruise healer. Lose the bruise with Dr. Hauschka's Ouch Aid.
Shirley B. slamming, jamming for the Port Authority. Unable to make her initial pass cleanly before Little Payne breaks through to be the lead jammer. Slamming now, who almost picked up the lead on her own, now on her scoring run. Little Payne already through the pack, picking up four more for Boston, calling off the jam and denying slamming any points of her own.
Boston's had some turnover on their team. They've the team that you're seeing today and in this tournament is mostly new skaters compared to seasons past, and it's a testament to the program they have there, not just the skaters themselves, that they can rebound from losing several skaters so quickly, and it's a great testament to the program and training they're doing there. Grim Demise on the inside. She breaks through. She is the lead jammer.
Grim Demise jumping around like she has bouncy balls on her skates. It's just incredible to see the agility of her through the pack. She is the lead jammer. She calls off the jam as Sugar hits just right on her tail. And so we see another double zero jam. No advantage there.
Anita Banger in the box. Number 21 for Boston.
And we've said this, we've made mention of this before, as Maine's Port Authority sets up the mass proposal as they all take a knee. Jam gets started, but this really has been a fairly low penalty bout. It's really been about track control, not taking advantage of penalties, Mellow Joe.
Well, as you say that, Grim Demise is your lead jammer here. And Shank trying to catch up.
Both girls on the scoring run. Grim Demise having an opportunity here to add to Maine's score. Looks through the middle. And goes to the outside, pushed out by Bumpus, calls off the jam. And adds two more unanswered.
You know, back to the penalties thing, though. We're late in the game now, and you could see a lot of those three minors turn into a fourth and a trip to the box, because they do add up, and they rear their ugly head a lot of times late in the bout. So if any of these skaters lose their focus, we could see some more penalty time. We could see that pick up. But Boston, they're definitely bigger offenders of breaking the rules today. Far more penalties than Maine.
Which doesn't reflect in the score. Little Payne on the outside, jamming for the Massacre. She's the lead jammer. Spry Icicle for the Port Authority. Goes down in the front straightaway. You know, something else we usually see at this point in the game, Mellow Joe, especially with a spread like this, we often see a lot of frustration set in. We see the aggression pick up, and we start to see a lot more penalties as Little Payne breaks through and picks up a natural grand slam. But we're not seeing that here. Maine is remaining cool, calm, and collected, and keeping their composure, staying on the track, not getting those penalties. And that, too, is a testament to the camp that the Port Authorities have.
Little Payne now running into a wall of Maine blockers. Seems like everyone's getting in on the action there.
Spry Icicle only now making her initial pass as Little Payne looking to increase this jam total and does so for a total of 9 for this jam. And we have a team timeout called by Maine's Port Authorities. Mellow Joe.
Maine probably looking to regroup here after that jam.
We're sitting at the 5-minute mark. Score 166 to 51. And with Boston so far ahead, are you surprised that Maine is still able to maintain this kind of composure? Because we see it time and time again.
It really is remarkable that they've kept such level heads so far, spending much less time in the penalty box. And that's unusual because Boston has spent a lot of time in the penalty box, just being a little rougher out on the track, a little more physical game from Boston. And normally you see that reflected in the score where you're team most prone to offending is oftentimes finds themselves trying to catch up. But oddly enough, that's not the case in this bout. Tonight's broadcast is being brought to you by Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates is the industry pioneer in boot sizing and configuration for women's feet. Split last and narrow skates are in stock and ready to ship to you.
Port Authorities dropping into a mass proposal. And the jam gets started.
Trying to get their jammer off the line as quickly as possible with two Boston blockers in the box.
Claire D. Wade, though, takes advantage as she hops through turn two to be the lead jammer. Grim Demise only now making her initial pass. But it's Claire D. Wade clearing a path down to the inside, and is she able to hold her skates on the line? She does. Picks up 4 for Boston. Clarity Way allowing 4 from Grim Demise. So it's a wash currently, but Clarity Way is back in the pack. Looks to the outside past Itsy Bitsy Fighter, goes to the inside of the back straightaway, adds 4 more, and decides to keep it going. Grim Demise whips past Anorexia, adding 4, and we're in an 8-8 jam.
Looks like Claire DeWay is going to try and pick up a couple more points and call off the jam.
But Claire DeWay getting sent to the penalty box. She's not going to get the opportunity. A track cut gives up a power jam to Grim Demise. And Grim Demise now with a grand slam.
Grim Demise, just a star jammer for Maine tonight. Doing such an excellent job here.
Grim Demise with, by my count, 13 so far in this jam. Whips to the outside. Looks to the inside, and a hop allows for another grand slam. And a total of 18.
Late night, we've seen a lot of skates this weekend. But if you need to buy new skates, it's an easy website to remember. You think you can remember this one?
I'll try.
BuyNewSkates.com.
That one I think I can remember.
If you need to buy new skates, BuyNewSkates.com. Also, we need to thank Blood and Thunder Magazine, worldwide roller derby coverage, and the World Cup. That's Blood and Thunder Magazine. It's a great source for in-depth roller derby coverage.
Mellow Joe, I tell you, watching Grim Demise able to hop through the pack is one of the most entertaining things we've seen so far today. The agility is, in my opinion, second to none, at least here today in Baltimore. Still in the middle of a timeout.
Looks like our jam is about to get underway.
If you're just now joining us, Boston leads Maine 174-69 here at the WFTDA East Region Playoffs, day two.
Skaters at the Dr. Hauschka start line.
Claire DeWay sitting in the penalty box still, allowing Maine to start this jam off in a power jam, and it's going to be Grim Demise taking advantage of it again. Jams back to back for Grim as she goes to the outside and tries to speed her way through, but gets shut down by Massacre's defense. Banger not allowing Grim through, and Little Punisher trying to help out Grim, but getting sent to the penalty box for it. Grim Demise getting battered around, but finally makes her way through as the power jam turns into a power failure. No points scored in this power jam. Claire DeWay and Grim Demise trying to skate through as Claire DeWay showing some agility, hopping over a skater but unable to pick up any points.
That was very close, but unable to do so. Those hips have to have passed the opposing blocker's hips to be counted as a point. And she just barely missed it.
Another mass proposal set up by Maine. Spry Icicle on the jammer line for Maine. Little Pain for Boston. Icicle on the outside. Looks to get past Mames. Does not do so. And it's going to be Little Pain through the pack first. She's the lead jammer. Little Pain having an effective night so far as Spry Icicle also on her scoring run now. Little Pain trying to find it past a line of main blockers, decides to call it off, picking up two, and we have another team timeout called by Maine.
We'd like to thank Five Stride Skate Shop, the preferred skate shop of Bonnie Thunder's Deranged, Psychobabble, Susie Hot Rod, and Teflon Donna. That's Five Stride Skate Shop. Also, we'd like to thank Derby Supply, the best customer service in the business, period. That's Derby Supply. Four Flying Dog is the official beer of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs.
You know, we've got still quite a bit more Derby to play. We're coming up just on what will likely be the last jam of this bout. Who do we have coming up next, Mellow Joe?
The next bout?
Yes.
Looks like, if my schedule is correct, it should be Gotham versus Steel City at 2 p.m. Eastern.
That'll be the first time we've seen Gotham play. They had the scrimmage that they played to take place of the forfeited Dutchland.
And the action is back underway. Cleared away on the line. Also, Grim Demise on the line for Maine.
It's going to be Claire DeWay breaking through the pack. She's the lead jammer. But it'll be nice to see Gotham in an actual bout here at the Eastern Playoffs. Claire calls off the jam. No points for Maine on that one. And that could be it.
Are you a Warrior late night?
I am.
Warrior-.com is where you need to go. We've seen a lot of skate merchandise. Lots of leagues have a lot of great merchandise. You can go to merchmama.com. She's supplying swag to the Derby Nation. Could be just what your league needs.
Well, I'll tell you, they can go to merchmama.com, but Boston is going to the next winner's bracket as they defeat Maine 176-69. And what about a lot bigger spread than we thought, Mellow Joe?
Yes. Like we said earlier, we kind of expected a Boston win, although it's hard to expect anything in a regional playoff. So we did think Boston was going to edge this one out, but not by such a margin. We were expecting something more in the 20 to 30 point range. Fairly evenly matched teams, or at least so we thought. But Boston, just with an exclamation point, winning this one, cleared away for Boston 54 points of her own. Shank picked up 21 points of her own. Ginger Kid and her single jam picked up 5 points. Lil Payne with 31 points, and Sugar Hits with 65 points for Boston. For Maine, on the flip side, Crystal Whip picked up 3 points, Grim Demise with 58, and Spry Icicle with 8 points of her own. The Maine jammers just had a hard time penetrating the Boston defense. There was some excellent teamwork in the pack today from Boston. It was just incredible.
Absolutely. Don't forget to fill out those brackets on WFTDA.com if you haven't already, and to upgrade to the HD stream if you're not already watching it there. More action here from Baltimore, Maryland at the Dewburns Arena in the WFTDA East Region Playoffs, presented by Blaze Media. For Mellow Joe, I'm Late Night Lyle. Stick around.